Hey guys, so today I have my first ever dupes video. I've never done one on my channel somehow, but I was realizing recently that I've been finding a lot of great alternatives to high-end products that I used to really enjoy. Some of them are very hyped up, and some of them are pretty exact dupes. Some of them are more like alternatives that if you like the vibe of the high-end version, you might also enjoy the cheaper options. So on one side of my face, I have high-end products, and the other side I have drugstore. Now specifically pay attention to my under eye concealer, my highlighter, my eyeshadow, and my lip gloss. Those are the four products that I have dupes for on my face right now. I would love to hear your guesses in the comments before I get into it, which side you think is drugstore and which side you think is high-end. And let's go ahead and get on into the dupes. I'm so excited. Hopefully this will help you save some money. Let's start with my concealer. The concealer that I love that I've been searching for a dupe for is the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. I've had this in my collection for a very long time, and I really like this concealer because it's the perfect happy medium between high coverage and a nice skin-like hydrated finish. And I do think it's hard to find that in a concealer. So I recently picked up the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer, totally not expecting it to be a dupe. I wasn't expecting to like this because I am pretty picky when it comes to concealers. I find that they either don't offer enough coverage or they look too dry on my under eyes. They accentuate fine lines. So I wasn't a huge fan of the original e.l.f. Camo Concealer because it was just a little bit too drying for my skin, but I was actually blown away by how much I like this, and I absolutely think it's a dupe for the Too Faced Born This Way concealer. I actually think I might like it even a little bit better. They both have a very creamy texture, but not so creamy that they're like slipping and sliding all over your face. And I feel like they offer just about the same level of coverage. Neither one is the absolute highest coverage you could ever find, but they're really good coverage, and they're about as high coverage as you could get while still looking skin-like. So I'm wearing the e.l.f. concealer on my right eye. My right side, which is your left side, I believe, is the drugstore side. Left side is high end. And keep in mind, my left under eye does have a slightly deeper set, I think, and I do have a little bit more of a shadow naturally on this under eye than this one. So it's hard to compare different under eye products on either eye because this eye just looks darker naturally. But you'll see in the demo as well, I can't really tell the difference between these two as far as coverage and finish. They both have that beautiful hydrated finish. I always set my under eye concealer. Both of them will settle into some fine lines. That's an issue that I have with just about every concealer I've ever tried. But I do set them, and I feel like, I can't tell that I'm wearing two different concealers. I actually think I like the e.l.f. side a little bit better. I think it has even a little bit more coverage. So to me, this is a total dupe. I know everyone has different experiences with different concealers depending on maybe how the ingredients work on your exact skin type, but for me, these are the same. So the e.l.f. one does come with less product, but I did calculate the cost per ounce, and the cost per ounce of the e.l.f. one is still about half the cost of the Too Faced one. So still a much better deal. I'm just so happy to have tried this. I don't know why it took me so long to pick this up. I mean, I know why. It's because I had a lot of concealers in my collection that I wanted to work through, but I just couldn't wait any longer. I had to try it because I'd heard a lot of good things about it, and I'm so glad I did. The shade that I have in the e.l.f. one is Light Ivory, and I have the shade Snow in the Too Faced one. Next, I have a highlighter, and I actually have two dupes for this highlighter. So it is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector. I have the shade Champagne Pop. This has been my all-time favorite highlighter for a long time now, probably going on 2 years at this point. And Becca recently announced that they are closing down later this year in September, which I was saddened and just more so just surprised to hear that because they're a huge brand. But I know a lot of people love their highlighters. For the longest time, nothing could touch this. This was the best highlighter I'd ever tried, and I did not think it would be possible to find a comparable option. As you can see, I have hit major pan on this mini that I have here. I actually have two dupes. One of them is actually a pretty close shade dupe to this, and the other is more of a formula dupe. So the shade dupe that I found is, unfortunately or fortunately, depending on who you are, is part of a face palette. It is the BH Cosmetics Weekend Vibes Belgian Waffle Palette. This is a six color palette that comes with three bronzers and three highlighters. First of all, I have so quickly fallen in love with this palette. My friend actually decluttered this to me. I had never tried BH Cosmetics before. I had no idea. I didn't know anything really about the products. I was absolutely floored the first time I used this. But these two shades down here actually, I think are very similar to Champagne Pop from Becca. They're slightly different in undertone, but they honestly are very similar. Today I'm wearing the shade Powdered Sugar on my right cheekbone, and I have Becca Champagne Pop on my left cheekbone. And I actually prefer the BH Cosmetics side, believe it or not. I think it looks even a little bit smoother on my skin, whereas the Becca one is just a little bit more like sparkly. I just feel like the BH Cosmetics one blends into my skin tone so seamlessly, it's almost ridiculous. Like, I did not know it was possible for a highlighter to go on that smoothly. For the longest time, that's what the Becca one was to me. I didn't know it was possible for a highlighter to blend in even smoother than this one, but the BH Cosmetics one looks so good on my skin. The downside to a face palette like this is, you may not find all of the shades useful for your skin tone. Like for me, this deepest highlighter, Maple, is a little bit too deep for my skin tone, but I can use all three of these bronzers. Actually, this bronzer called Buttermilk is super light, like it's almost the same color as my skin tone, it's just a little bit deeper. That is the perfect subtle bronzer tone for my skin. I'm usually not a bronzer person, but I love that bronzer and it blends in so well. So, even being not really a face palette person, I love this palette already and I can see myself getting so much use out of this. But that highlighter formula is phenomenal. If you think you would get enough use out of those shades, I highly recommend this face palette. Now, if you are more of a single highlight kind of person, you're not really into face palettes, a single version that I think is very comparable to the Becca formula is the Estate Do Me Baked Highlighter Powder. I have the shade Lit, and this is not an exact shade dupe to the Becca one. Unfortunately, I only have two cheeks, so I wasn't able to demo this one today as well. But I do think, and you'll see in the swatch, I do think that the feel and the way that this applies is very similar to the Becca one. I have the shade Lit in the Estate highlighter, and it is a little bit lighter than Champagne Pop. It's interesting because I normally think of baked cheek products as maybe having the potential to be a little bit more dry, but this goes on very smooth and it doesn't feel dry at all. And I feel like it has a very similar effect to the Becca one on my cheeks. And Estate is kind of a lesser known brand, but they are, I received this in PR from them. They are Leaping Bunny certified, so they are cruelty free. And I don't hear very many people talking about them, but of the products I've tried from them, I really like the highlighter a lot. Moving on to eyeshadow. So I have been raving and raving about the Urban Decay Stoned Vibes eyeshadow palette for ever since I got it. I love this palette. This is a 12-pan eyeshadow palette. It comes with eight of these really unique, creamy, sparkly, foiled duochrome shimmers. Those were a lot of adjectives, and four kind of satin matte shades. And I love this palette. Unfortunately, it is limited edition, so this won't be around forever. Lately, I have actually seen it on sale in quite a few places for like half off. So if you've been wanting to get this, now is the time. I have found a drugstore palette that is definitely not an exact dupe for this. It's not a shade for shade dupe. It's not a formula dupe either, but it does kind of scratch the same itch as the Urban Decay Stone Vibes palette, and it is the Flower Beauty Jungle Lights palette. Yeah. So this one is only a six-pan palette and it is all shimmer. So right off the bat, that is a pretty big difference compared to the Stone Vibes palette. Also, the feel and the formula is a little bit different, but the Flower palette is that kind of foiled shimmer that has kind of a similar effect on the eyes. So I am of course wearing the flower one on my right eye, your left, and the Urban Decay palette on my left eye. I think that these palettes do satisfy a similar kind of need that you might have if you really enjoy, like, let's say the ColourPop Super Shock shadows or the discontinued e.l.f. Long Lasting Lustrous eyeshadow in the Little Pot. These both kind of fall under the same category. The main difference, I think, is just the formula of them. The Urban Decay shadows have a little bit of a sheerer base to them, and the finish is a lot more of like that kind of glimmery, sparkly finish that I love. The shimmers almost give like this scattered effect on your eyelid, whereas the flower ones have more of an opaque base and a very foiled metallic finish. So it's a slightly different finish that you're getting, but I think if you like the Stone Vibes palette, or if the Stone Vibes palette sounds like something you would like, you would also like the flower one. They're both the kinds of shimmers that you're going to want to apply with your fingers, and they're just really fun to use if you are a shimmer lover. One slight downside to the flower one that I've noticed is that if you apply too much, they have the capacity to look a little bit like wrinkly on your eyelid. I don't have particularly wrinkly eyelids at this point, but they can kind of like build up in an unflattering way, so you definitely don't want to apply too much. I have not had that problem with the Urban Decay one that I can remember. So you may not love the flower one as much if you have mature lids, or if you do have mature lids. What a weird phrase, mature lids. If you have more mature skin around your eyes, you may just want to be careful and apply a thin amount of this. But either way, the flower one is $17. The Urban Decay one originally retailed for $54, but like I said, I've seen it on sale for as low as $27, at least in the US. So still at least $10 cheaper, the flower one, compared to the sale price of the Urban Decay. Now, it is also half as many shades. One of the great things about the Urban Decay one is that it does come with some mattes that go with it. But if you just really love that foiled, sparkly formula, I don't think you'll be disappointed by the flower one either if you do want to save some money. That being said, I enjoy having both of these in my collection. I feel like they both add value to my collection. They're different enough that I feel like it's worth having both, but you also don't need both. So this is certainly, hang on, there's a honking vehicle. Isn't it crazy how often this kind of thing happens? Like how often you hear car alarms going off? So these are certainly not exact dupes, but I think if you really wanted to try the Urban Decay one, but it was just too expensive, try this one. Try the flower one because it's got that similar kind of vibe. So next for my lips, I have two different lip glosses on. The shades are not the same. This is not a shade dupe. This is more of a formula, a similar formula. I won't even say formula dupe because it's not. It's more of an alternative again. But one of my favorite higher end gloss formulas is the Dose of Colors gloss. I have the shade On Repeat. This is the one that I have on my right side, and a similar formula that I think will, that you'll be satisfied with if you've been wanting to try the Dose of Colors one, is the Milani Keep It Full glosses. Now this is technically a plumping gloss, whereas the Dose of Colors one I don't think claims to be plumping. Personally, I don't feel like plumping glosses ever really do a whole lot for me as far as actually making my lips plump, like physically plump up. I think in general, glosses are just going to make your lips look more plump because they're shiny and they just make your lips look more full. That being said, the Milani one does have a slight minty cooling feel, whereas the Dose of Colors one does not, but it's not painful by any means. I know there's some lip plumpers that will like tingle and hurt your lips. That's not this. But the reason why I think these are similar is that they both have a similar feel, a similar level of shine, and a similar level of opacity to them. So some glosses will be a lot more sheer. If you see like a color in the tube, you're gonna get like a much sheer kind of watered down version of that color. Both of these really do show up like this color in a pretty opaque way. And I think if that is what you like about the Dose of Colors gloss, I think you would also really like the Milani one. Packaging is different. The Milani one has a slightly chubbier applicator, whereas the Dose of Colors one is more of like a thinner paddle shaped applicator. But to me, the Milani gloss has a very luxe feel to it despite being from a drugstore brand. So I really enjoy this. These shades are not the same. In the Milani gloss, I have the shade Soft Rose, which is a slightly cooler pink, whereas the Dose of Colors On Repeat shade is a little bit more tan. But they actually are pretty similar. I think if you didn't know that I was wearing two different shades, you might not even notice. So once again, not an exact dupe, but very similar. So good alternative that will save you some money. So I also have a couple of hair care dupes, and these brands, I think, I'm not positive, but I think they are sister companies. I read that somewhere online, but I wasn't able to like confirm it. But I think that they have to be related in some way, because if you look at the ingredients between each brand for like comparable products, they're very similar. They're not identical, but they're similar. And those brands are Amika and Eva NYC. So between these two brands, I think you'll be able to find a lot of dupes. But the first one that I have from them are their texture sprays. So I have the Amika Undone Volume and Matte Texture Spray and the Eva NYC City Grit Matte Texture Spray. Both of these I received in PR via Octoly, just as a disclaimer. But these just do the same thing. And I think that, you know, I'll go ahead and use them both. I haven't actually applied any texture spray to my hair yet today, so there's that one. Oh, I'm mixing it up. This is the high-end side. The Eva NYC is the cheaper one, but I'm putting it on the side that I've been putting high-end products. They do have slightly different scents. The Eva NYC one actually smells kind of similar to me to the Dry Bar texture spray that I love, the Dry Bar Triple Sec. The Dry Bar Triple Sec is my all-time favorite. These have a little bit more grit to them, and I do kind of prefer the lighter, like, airier feel of the Dry Bar one, but if you like a more gritty feel, these are so similar. I feel like they're practically the same thing. I mean, yeah, even just looking at the ingredients, especially the first, like, half of the ingredients list are the same. So, yeah, save you some money. And I think the same goes for most Amika products. If you love an Amika product, check Eva NYC to see if they have a product with like a similar name or, you know, similar claims. You'll probably be able to find a dupe. The other dupe from the two brands that I have, Amika The Wizard Detangling Primer and the Eva NYC Main Magic 10-in-1 Primer, both again were received through Octoly. These are the same. They have the same claims, pretty much. Prevent breakage, they're meant to protect against heat, reduce blow-dry time, detangle. Same claims, really the same feel. They both have this kind of liquidy oil consistency to them. They both give my hair a little bit of softness, and I just use them both as like a heat protectant before I style. So those are all of my dupes that I had to share with you today. I had so much fun putting this video together. I definitely want to film more dupes videos in the future once I, of course, find more dupes. But I hope this was helpful. I hope it saved you a little bit of money. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. I upload 2 to 3 videos every week, and I'd love to see you again soon. And hopefully I'll talk to you in my next video. Bye.